Robin and Dan, this alleged cover-up is widespread and it involves CPD officers and employees. The act that they were trying to conceal is Johnson allegedly driving after a night of drinking. A source telling the Chicago Sun-Times the alleged cover-up could be worse than the actual incident itself. Now, on October 16th, Johnson was seen on video having drinks at Ceres Cafe inside Chicago's Board of Trade building. He was then accompanied by a woman, not his wife. Sources tell the Sun-Times the two were seen kissing on that video, and we now know the woman Johnson was seen with was part of his security detail. Johnson promoted her to that position, and she has since been reassigned to another role within the police department. Now, hours after Johnson and the woman were spotted drinking, Johnson was seen slumped over the wheel of his SUV in the midnight hour of October 17th. He was on 34th Place in Aberdeen, that's blocks away from his Bridgeport home. A call was placed to dispatchers and officers responded. Once officers responded, sources tell the Sun-Times Johnson rolled down his window halfway, flashed his badge, and had a brief conversation with officers before driving away. Johnson released a two-page statement via his attorney yesterday acknowledging this series of events, saying, "I did not intentionally mislead or deceive the mayor or the people of Chicago. I acknowledge that I made a poor decision and had a lapse of judgment on the night of October 16th. I have no interest in fighting a battle for my reputation with those who want to question it now." Johnson saying that he feels, despite the fact that he was fired by the mayor, he feels he still left his position in with integrity, and that integrity is still intact. Johnson also has yet to talk to the IG, the Inspector General, about this, although they have reached out multiple occasions to try to get him to speak and give his take.